Atari versus Sega. Ooh, yeah! The Immortal John Hancock here, and today I'm continuing my retro gaming playoffs with round two. That's right, the votes are in. You voted for the winners of round one, and I'm here to announce them with a few comments from you folks. I'm having a lot of fun. For people new to my channel or new to this retro gaming playoffs, what I did is I took eight products from 2018, retro gaming products, and matched them up head-to-head, and with you determining who moves on to the next round. So for the last 2 weeks, you've been able to vote by commenting on particular videos to see who moves on to the next round. And the results are in! That's right! We had two Atari products, the Atari Flashback 9 versus the Retron 77, and two Sega products. We had the Mega Retron HD versus the AtGames Flashback 2018 model. And the results are in. And the winners are... the Retron 77 hands down won by 68%, with hundreds of people voting. A lot of people had many things to say about the Retron 77. Now, first and foremost, I think it's important to note that this is first and foremost one of the very first affordable clones of the Atari 2600 that people have been able to play their Atari 2600 cartridges on an HD TV. I think that's important to note. And so some of the comments below, James B. said, gets my vote straight up because it isn't made by AtGames. Ouch! And Wonder Jensen, he said, commented by saying, kind of encourages you to get out and collect again. That's right. I think this is a pretty cool product because you can play original cartridges on it on an HD TV, and a lot of people agreed with that. A lot of people expressed that you can play 2600 cartridges. That was important to them. Retro Raider said, got it for Christmas and very happy with it. And so a lot of people commented how they liked the compatibility of the Retron 77 and the ability to play cartridges. Also, another Hyperkin product, the Mega Retron HD, also won versus the AtGames Flashback 2018. And this one was even more of a wallop. It got 82% of all the votes. It actually doesn't surprise me. It's a really good product. And so several people had lots of comments and things to say, and I tried to go through. And some of the most common ones, Brad Deller, and so he commented saying, plus one for running Virtua Racing. That's right. You know, that Virtua Racing is a special Genesis cart, and it has a SVP chip in it, and it's kind of like the Star Fox of Sega Genesis games, and it is hard to run on clone consoles, but the people at Hyperkin got it to work on the Mega Retron HD, so props to that. Also, Talks to Toad said the Mega Retron HD because it has better compatibility. That's right. It ran my multi-cart. It ran homebrews. It ran pretty much almost anything that I put into it. And so that's really a cool feature that it could run so many different things. Mumfat the Everliving said the option for region switch, the ability to play light gun on CRT, that alone was enough for me. That was another big feature of the Mega Retron HD, is that it had AV hookups in the back. And so if you wanted to play light gun games, you were able to do so. And so nice having that option for people that just wanted to play on a CRT or just play those light gun games. It was super important. And many people commented on that. And many people said because of the compatibility that they voted for the Mega Retron HD. So this is the round two, and now the choice is yours. So now you have the most epic matchup between Atari, the Retron 77, versus the Mega Retron HD, Sega Genesis. You are going to determine who goes on to the next round. That's right. I'm going to announce the rules, talk about the bracket, And more importantly, you vote by just commenting below. Some people ask, well, why don't you do a survey? Well, this is more fun. A, you're not going to know the outcome, so it's not going to affect who you're going to vote for. And so I like tallying up the comments. It gives people more freedom. It also counts as engagement on my channel. That's the truth of the matter. So commenting below helps me out, and it gives you some freedom to elaborate on your plus one for the Retron 77 or plus one for the Mega Retron HD, and you can explain why. Now, I'm going to look at those comments because some of them are going to be read on a future video. Have fun with these. I love reading these. I read every single one of them. Thank you so much, and let the games begin. All right, looking at the schedule moving forward today, obviously it's going to be the Retron 77 and the Mega Retron HD, and voting is going to be open until January 22nd till midnight. And then on Thursday, I'm going to have the winner of the quarter scale Pac-Man versus the 1-Up Arcade Pac-Man go against the winner of the R9 handheld, also known as a Soldier Boy, or the new BitBoy handheld. So it's going to be an epic match versus, you know, an arcade device versus kind of like a clone device. And the winner of that will go against the winner of this. And then the Super Bowl will be on January 24th. And then voting will be, I'm going to have voting open until about a week. And then the announcement, the champion, will be announced on my channel on January 31st. So I'm having a lot of fun with this. Please vote and game on. All right, the rules are as follows. Users may vote for their favorite device featured in this video. This is done by commenting and doing a plus one with the device's name in the comment section. I do need a plus one. It makes voting easier. And if you don't do a plus one or aren't clear on who you're determining, I'm not going to count your vote. Voting will be tallied up after a scheduled and announced time. For this video, it's going to be midnight, January 22nd, Pacific Standard Time. That's right. The device that has the most votes in the comment section will move on. You may only vote once per video. And I do appreciate the comments. I do try to read all of them, and I'll tally it up as best as I can and announce some of these comments on a future video. So there you have it. That's right. You choose the winner of this round, and I'm excited about doing this. I had hundreds of people participate. I read every single comment. It was great. And I just, you know, I'm having a lot of fun. This is kind of a fun way of doing January videos, you know. And one thing, you know, I spend a lot of time on my YouTube channel, and I do it around a full-time job. This is my hobby, my passion, my love. And, you know, if you're going to spend a lot of time on something, it might as well be fun and great. And it keeps me going. It keeps me excited about doing videos, and I'm having a lot of fun with this. Thank you so much to everybody who participated, who commented, who said a nice thing, or even just said a thing. And it means the world to me, and I'm having a lot of fun as I march towards 80,000 subs. That's right. You help. You make a difference. This is for you folks. That's right. I love having people engaged and participating and determining the outcome. And if you want to continue to contribute, I have a Patreon. For as little as a dollar a month, you get an extra video. That's right. I do an extra video for people who contribute just a dollar a month every month. You folks are wonderful and beautiful. This is the immortal John Hancock. Thank you, and you take care. Another shout out to another channel and friend who I think has a great channel and covers a lot of classic gaming, arcades, classic, handhelds, you name it. And that goes to Arcade USA, a friend who's reached out to me several times. I've had a couple things break on my channel. He's willing to fix them. He is a very knowledgeable person. He's also on Atari Age, and I think he's got a great channel, and he's just a good guy. Just a good guy all around. Check out Arcade USA. He's got a lot of videos. He's got like 1,200 videos on YouTube, and is very knowledgeable. Also a Coleco fan, and so check out his channel. gets a big thumbs up from me.